Good morning and welcome to Wholesome Roots. Today is another edition of Natural Goat Care where I'm going to show you how to check the ligaments in a goat to find out if they're getting close to kidding.
This is Kitty. She is a fourth freshener, I believe. And she is 3 days away from her kidding due date. So she has been acting pretty uncomfortable. So we start looking at the ligaments and seeing what they're doing. So when somebody says, did you check their ligaments? And they're talking about a goat that's possibly in labor. So what they're referring to is located right here. And what we're gonna look for is right here at the hip bone and right here where the tail breaks off from the body. In between, usually about halfway, there's gonna be a somewhat hollow depression with one single pencil-like shape ligament going through. So that ligament goes from, I can feel the top of it right here, from the backbone down to this bone here. So it runs from here to here, from the tip of this finger, from the tip of this finger. And it runs just like that. When you press here, you can feel that ligament. When a goat is at the early stages of pregnancy, that ligament is very firm and solid. It cannot be moved. As the pregnancy increases and gets closer to kidding, this tendon is going to get softer and softer and softer. So when they say, are the ligaments gone? They don't actually disappear. They just get so soft that you can't hardly feel them anymore. So my fingertips are rolling on the tendon. I can feel it. It's still there. It's not soft or squishy. It's still firm. So she is probably good for today. I will have Ryan check her ligaments tonight, and we will continue checking morning and night until we see any other signs of kidding. So once that ligament has become squishy soft to the point where you can't find it anymore, it will be so soft that you'll be digging in a hollow. This hollow will almost be visible to the eye. And in this hollow, it'll be soft and squishy. You'll be able to put your fingers together underneath the backbone, under the tailbone, and touch your fingertips together. See, right now, I have about an inch in between my fingertips. So we still got room to go still. And when those ligaments are gone, it's going to be really, really noticeable. So another clue to look for if a goat is becoming close to kidding is to look at the vulva. The vulva will be puffy, it will be swollen, it will be even possibly dripping. If it's dripping a string of goo that's amber colored or clear, then you know that you are probably within 24 hours of kidding, or much less in many cases. Kitty gets a very dramatic slope. So you see the slope from her hip bone to her tailbone. That's going to be like, it goes from this to like this when she is ready to kid. So that's another sign that you can physically see. Another sign that you're going to physically see is right here. Above where the babies are is going to look hollow, and the goat's going to look really thin compared to what it looked like the day before. And that means that the babies have dropped, and that means that they have dropped into the birth canal to prepare for birth. There are a million other clues and signs, and every goat is different. You're gonna have a different experience with your goat than my goat, than your neighbor's goat. So make sure that you just really pay attention to the signs and clues. Some of the things to look for are changes in behavior, standing off to the side away from the other goats, not wanting to come out of the stall in the morning and go out to the pasture. Kitty often, when I know she's ready to kid, she stays in the stall. She's so easy to tell. She's such a textbook case most of the time that I've just really enjoyed using her as my example in my videos. I have tons of birthing videos on YouTube that you can watch. You can check out the playlist for goat birthing, or the full goat playlist will have many things throughout it as well. another thing that people look for in whether or not a doe is ready to kid is the udder. Kitty's udder has been full for a couple of weeks now. So until that udder suddenly looks hard as a rock and the teats stand straight away because they're firm too, I don't go by the udder as much as I do the other signs. I have had does that had big, huge udders a month before they kidded, and I have had does that had no udder an hour before they kidded. So, yes, udder can help you depending on the goat. If you know the characteristic of that goat and what it normally does in the timeline of getting the body prepared for kidding, then you might be able to go off of some of those clues for that animal. But if this is a new goat to you and you've never been through the situation with it, you really, really are gonna have a hard time knowing until those kids are on the ground. So a goat pawing at the ground, a goat making more noise, being more friendly, more vocal. These are all things you want to look out for. So really any changes in behavior or body can be great clues to help you figure out if your doe is about to kid. Once the ligaments are gone, I typically see labor progress within 12 hours, not 24, but it is normal for it to be 24. But I usually, once they're absolutely gone, it's usually within 12 hours for us. So keep an eye out for that. I think that's one of the best ways to really tell. And the goose string, those are the two best ways to tell if your goat is actually going to be kidding in the next 24 hours. I hope this has helped you. Please check out our playlist for the Natural Goat Care series and find out some more great things about learning about your goats. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment down below, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time on Wholesome Roots.